My name is Munkiran Dinoa. I'm a third-year student at McMaster in the Integrated Science program. During this past semester, I've been working on a research project in a lab at McMaster that uses induced pluripotent stem cells. Induced pluripotent stem cells are essentially cells that are capable of differentiating into any cell type within the body. And they give us a lot of potential to study diseases that are specific to certain tissues. The lab that I'm currently working in is using induced pluripotent stem cells to create a model of endothelial cell dysfunction and the role this plays in coronary artery disease. So coronary artery disease is a disease that is specific to endothelial cells lining the blood vessels, and it's often present in those who have risk factors such as obesity, diabetes, or sedentary lifestyle. However, there are a group of individuals who have early onset coronary artery disease and do not possess any of these risk factors but still develop the disease at an early age. It is believed that these individuals may have a genetic basis to developing this disease, one that has to do with the endothelial cells within their body. By creating a model of endothelial cell dysfunction, we can begin to study some of the differences between endothelial cells in people with coronary artery disease and those who are healthy. My component of the research project is the characterization of these endothelial cells obtained from patient samples that have been differentiated from stem cells, and comparing these endothelial cells to healthy endothelial cells derived from donors, and determining whether these endothelial cells are truly a model of endothelial cells found within the body. So by doing this, we can pave the way for the development of future therapies in order to treat coronary artery disease in these individuals. And by doing so, we can improve the clinical outcome because it is very poorly understood.